things together from different places, often things that you wouldn't think go together. And if you follow my other series, like Georgina or Vampire Academy, you know that there are often very conflicting themes. Like, sometimes it'll be super wacky and just ridiculous. And then other times you've got that heartbreaking, gut-wrenching, take your heart out and, you know, stomp it on the floor kind of thing. And then it'll go back to being ridiculous and wacky. And I just really love that. I love pairing different things together. And so Gameboard was kind of a coming together of a whole bunch of just really different kind of things. It actually started, I'd say about 10 years ago, when I was getting my master's degree in comparative religion. And I was studying all these wonderful religions and mythologies around the world. And I just, you know, I was thinking, you know, it's so incredible the way humans have gravitated toward these and they've become so integrated into our society. And I wondered, what would it be like if you just took that away? What if you said, no more religion, can't do it, it's wrong? Would people come back to it? Would you eventually find a way to pull back towards your spiritual side? And that kind of forms the basis of the society in this book. The book takes place 100 years in the future after a group of religious extremists set off a virus that took out half the world's population. And after that, they made some governments a little uneasy about religion. And so the country that this book takes place in has done exactly that. They said, no religion unless you're licensed by the government to prove that you are not a threat to the state. So if you want to have a religion, you have to be inspected each year, prove that you're cool, and go on from that. And so that's one piece here that I put together. The other thing that I mixed in were some dysfunctional characters, because I like that. And you probably know that if you've read anything else. I love flawed, dysfunctional characters. And so my two leads are a guy and a girl who have a whole host of issues going on. And they're inspired by real-life things. They're not based on actual people. I never do that. I never write people into my books because I'm pretty sure that'll ruin a friendship. But I love finding personality quirks in people. And actually, one of my own personality quirks is in this book. The female character, May, she is a soldier in this country that the book takes place in. A super soldier who has enhanced reflexes and fighting and a whole host of other things. And she's also very emotionally withdrawn. And this comes a little bit, actually, from my own childhood. I grew up with a lot of very big personalities, very volatile personalities with a lot of issues. And when you grow up around people like that, you often find the best way to sort of cope is to not have that kind of personality. You know, there are people that need to be center stage, and you just need to take a step back. And so I grew up being very reserved and just hiding what I feel, don't let it show, to the extent now that when it's totally fine to do that, I still sometimes have to let it out more. And that's certainly something I've learned to do, and I have great outlets like writing for my emotions. But I thought, what if you had that kind of personality template, and then you were put into a soldier role where you're also forced to be disciplined, you know, to be reserved? What does that do to a person? Is that eventually going to set you off? Are you going to get wound up so tightly that do you snap? And so there's my next piece in this world. The other piece is a good one. They're all good. my guy lead in here, his name is Justin, and he is loosely based, again, loosely, and not an import of a person I know, but a guy I used to go to grad school with. And this guy was great. I loved him. He was a total party guy. We would go out with him, and he would just drink and take other things he really should not have, things that should have put him in a coma. And, like, at the time, it's like, haha, there he goes again, you know, drinking, doing acid, smoking pot all at the same time. And now, like, I look back at that, and I was like, that was so stupid. You know, that was really unsafe. But that was the kind of guy he was. He was just always doing that kind of stuff. And we would go out to bars, and we would lose him. Like, we'd all be sitting together, and he'd get up to go to the bathroom, and, like, 2 hours later, we'd notice he never came back. And we'd find him off somewhere, like, making new friends and stuff. We found him one night trying to convert some guy to polygamy. He was at the bar next to this 80-year-old guy, and he's like, dude, multiple wives. We're just like, okay, come on, time to go home. And he was also very much a ladies' man. He was very cute. I'm glad I had a boyfriend at the time. And he was like dating multiple girls at the same time and in other departments. And then they'd come after our department, like it was our fault. Like, why don't you keep him in line? And it's just like, dude, we can't control him, you know? It's what he does. And so he had all these crazy things going on. And then he would show up in class the next day, and it was just brilliance. Like, he was just razor-focused, and he would just expound on these just crazy philosophical things, and he knew Greek, and he knew Latin, and it was just amazing. And I was really fascinated with that kind of personality type. I was wondering, what makes a person flip back and forth? How do you live those dual sides? And I don't know the answer for my friend. I haven't seen him in years. Hope all's well with him. And that's where the similarity ends, because he's got his own story. And I made up my own story for what might drive that personality. And in this case, in the case of Justin in my book, he is someone who thinks too much. He analyzes the world. He sees things, and he looks, and he can, you know, just from the color of your shirt and the way you're standing, he can draw all these conclusions about you. And it drives him crazy so much, he wants to turn it off. And that's why he drowns himself in substances, in women, because he just wants to shut his mind down for a while. And so that was just a character type I had wanted to make. And after a while, these things came together, you know, my anti-religion world, my uptight soldier, my dueling sides guy. And this is how a lot of my books form. After a while, I just collect enough of these little things, and I was like, you know what, these are all cool. Can I jam them together and make a book out of it? And that's what this is. And so Gameboard takes place in this world, and the problem that these two dysfunctional characters find themselves soon facing is that they've been told religion is bad, you know, there is no supernatural, and then paranormal things start happening, and how do you deal with that? And so therein lies the story of Gameboard. I'm happy, totally happy if you want to talk more about that, if you have questions about that.